There we go. Now you some bitches can see me. Should have made the camera see my face before I did that. Forget that sometimes. Yeah. Let's get it on. Got things to do today. Episode 2 of The Walking Dead. Getting it on. Yeah.
It's so quiet. So quiet. Welcome to The Walking Dead.
Well, I already played episode 1, so, where's, episode 2? Ah, there we go. Episode 2, Starved for Help. Let's play. Oh, I hope my camera's in the right place. Five comments, but nobody watching. That makes no sense. There we go. One person, five comments. That don't make no sense. Come on, nigga.
Previously on The Walking Dead.
I know who you are.
I got another good one for you.
You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah, I want my parents to come home now.
And you keep an eye on that front door. You're our lookout.
It's Doug. You got it.
And I'm Carly.
Okay, Carly, you'll shift in with Doug.
You got it, boss.
Son of a bitch. One of them is bitten.
We reason with him.
With the bloody end of an axe handle, maybe. Nobody threatens my boy.
They got it.
Oh my God.
I had to save the person with the vagina.
But if anything happens to my daughter or that little girl you've got with you,
you better stop threatening her. I know that. I'm gonna have to whoop his old ass. Keep fucking around with Crawley.
The game series adapts to the choices you make. The story is tailored to how you play. Telltale Games presents. Three months later. Getting. Punk ass zombie.
What'd they get this time?
Looks like a rabbit.
Well, that's another meal lost. I still can't believe we went through all that commissary food in 3 months. It seemed like so much at the time.
Maybe you shouldn't have opened the door.
Yeah, except then I'd probably be food by now. Trust me, I have no regrets.
Rabbit's hardly a meal, Mark, but I'd take it. We're all hungry.
No kidding. When I accidentally grabbed for Carly's rations the other night, I thought she was gonna take off my hand.
We're all on edge. Just cut us some slack.
Yeah, you're right. I wish I knew for sure how much food we have left.
We'll manage.
Maybe. You know, some people aren't too happy about the way Lily's handling rations.
Lily knows it's important to keep the adults fed and functioning. Sometimes that means someone's gotta miss a meal.
You think Kenny's having any more luck than we are out here?
I sure hope so.
Yeah, between the lack of food and Kenny and Lily fighting all the time, things are getting pretty tense back at the Motor Inn. You know, Kenny's been talking about taking off if he can get that RV running.
Kenny won't abandon us. He's a good man.
Yeah, I guess we'll see. Can't blame him, though. Did you hear Larry going off on him last night? What's the old guy's deal, anyway? Seems like he's got a problem with you in particular.
He thinks I'm a danger to the group and Clementine.
I think he's the one putting us in danger. The way Lily worries about his health, I wouldn't be surprised if she's been skimming rations for him. And I know Lily thinks he's getting weaker, but the guy's all muscle. He's a walking pile driver. I know I wouldn't want to be stuck in a room with him. And didn't he punch you in the face one time?
Knock me flat.
A walking pile driver. Will that attract him?
Don't. Gunshot'll bring walkers. Or bird's not worth it.
Yeah, I know. I'm just really frickin' hungry.
Ah! Shit! Was that Kenny?
I don't know. Come on!
Walkers to kill anyway. No matter what, he's gonna get some danger.
Jesus Christ.
Ooh, oh, bear
shit.
Trap.
No. Please don't kill us. We just want to help our teacher. We'll leave, I swear.
Lee, you guys okay?
Get it off. Get it off. God damn it.
Come
get,
to walk
get it off me. Travis, maybe they can help.
These might be the same guys that raided our camp, and we barely got away from that.
What guys?
Why the fuck is there a bear trap out here?
It's okay. We're not going to hurt you.
Don't listen to them, Ben. Please, just let us go. We're not a threat to you.
Kid, chill out. We'll try to help you, but you gotta shut the fuck up.
Please, fucked up. Gotta help. Please.
Ben, shut up.
Okay, get
My
on the man's leg and
forces.
Help.
I know what I'm doing.
Just see if you can get him out. Dude. After that, you can leave us or whatever. I don't care. Please.
We gotta get him out of there.
Oh, God, thank you.
Fine, but you gotta hurry.
Hurry, please, hurry!
There we go. Dude, that was gonna happen.
Hey, this trap's been altered. There's no release latch.
Wow.
Oh no.
One, two.
Shit! Walkers! It's now or never, Lee!
Please! Get me out of this!
Mark, get the boys back! Kenny, keep those walkers off of me!
Oh God.
Really
God.
Just
leave
me out, please! All that blood and screaming? We're gonna be surrounded any minute!
Oh Jesus,
please.
Those things are gonna be here soon!
Get me out of this! Try to cut the chain!
Oh God!
I have to cut you out!
No! Try the trap again! Anything,
let's
please.
Go, let's go!
Fuck.
Lee, it has to be now!
God.
Grab him and let's go.
That happened in the series too when they cut off I forgot his name, but they cut off his leg, the old man's leg. He passed
behind
out.
You! Travis! Come on, we gotta move!
Come on, special forces.
No!
Disemboweled him. I have earned a trophy. Going hungry. Okay. Oh, God. Why'd I have to chop it so many fucking times? Oh, man. Now everybody's starting to file in. Okay. But try and jump on that What Culture video part one today for y'all. Just so you know. I've seen your comments. Like, damn it, stop with that fucking ball, kid.
Get the gates open! We've got wounded!
Shit! What the hell are they doing?
Come on!
Oh my god! What happened?
Oh,
what
the hell?
What's going on?
I don't have time to explain.
Lee, are you okay?
Get him into the truck. I'll see what I can do.
Cat,
okay?
Can you fix him?
Jesus, Ken.
Lee.
I don't know.
Lee! What the hell? You can't just be bringing new people here. What are you thinking?
Hey, you want to calm down for a fucking
hey,
minute?
No, I don't. I want to know why you thought bringing more mouths to feed was a good idea.
He would have died if we left him.
So what?
We are not responsible for every struggling survivor we come across. We have to focus on our group, right here, right now.
Well, hang on. We haven't even talked to these people yet. Maybe they can be helpful.
Come on, Lily. These are people. People trying to survive just like us. We've got to stick together to survive.
The only reason you're here is because you had food. Enough for all of us. But that food is almost gone. We've got maybe a week's worth left. And I don't suppose you guys are carrying any groceries, are you?
No.
Fine, you guys fight it out then. Welcome to the family, kid.
Come over here and see what I drew.
What? No, I...
Just come on, okay?
You know, you sound like something an adult would say to a kid. Group,
but we can make our own goddamn decisions.
Doesn't work.
This isn't your own personal dictatorship.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, you're being dramatic. Everything always turns into a power struggle between you two. I'm not gonna be a part of that.
Hey, I didn't ask to lead this group. Everyone was happy to have me distributing the food when there was enough to go around, but now that it's running out, suddenly I'm a goddamn Nazi.
Kenny's right. Yeah, you're in charge of the food and the schedules, but you're not in charge of people's lives.
Really?
You weren't there. Lee made a choice. End of story.
Yeah.
Once Katja patches that guy up, you can kick him out of here. Send him out on their own, I couldn't care less. But they at least deserve a fighting chance against the Walkers. And for the record, Kenny wanted to leave those people behind.
If Kenny would pull his head out of his ass for 5 seconds, he'd realize that I make these decisions to protect his family. We simply don't have enough food.
I don't see any of you stepping up to make the hard decisions. My girl's got more balls than all of you combined.
Dad, please.
I can't stand his ass.
Why don't you go help Mark with
the ball? I'ma let him get eaten or whatever if it ever happens. I get the opportunity.
You know what? If you think I'm doing such a shitty job, then you do it.
Okay.
That's all the food we have for today. You decide who gets to eat.
Lily.
No, I'm serious. Pick up that food and start handing it out. You see how it feels to not have enough food for everyone.
Here you go, Clementine. Four food items for 10 hungry people. I actually got to hand it out. Here.
Is he gonna be okay?
I don't know. Can you give me a hand real quick?
Sure. What do you need?
Just apply some pressure here while I try to close this up. You know, I thought I was starting to get used to this, sewing up people's injuries. But I mean, cuts and bruises are one thing, but Lee, this man has no leg.
I did the right thing.
Yeah, I know you did. The right thing is just scary sometimes, I guess. Well, you've done all you can, Lee. Thanks for the help. Go ahead and check in on the others. I need a little space here anyway.
She got big booty. She gonna be all right. She don't need no food.
Sturdy, but her snack gonna hold up forever, just like the rest of this place.
Yeah, I mean, she survive off her fat reserves.
At least the kids have something to keep them occupied. It keeps the walkers out. Carly's been doing the bulk of the lookout duty.
Well, he's the one that brought the food, so he deserved to get some.
Will you hold the damn board steady?
I'm trying. I didn't realize I was getting this weak already.
What do you want? A handout? Oh, I got 60 cents in my pocket, if you'll shut up and quit being such a pansy.
I hate that dude so much.
Hey, you holding up okay, Lee? I was pretty fucked up back there, having to cut that guy's leg off.
Yeah, I just hope Katja can save him. Here, eat something.
He's an army guy, so he likes jerky.
Thanks, Lee.
Need any help with the wall?
Nope.
Actually, we could use your axe. Do you mind if we take it?
Yeah, give us that thing for a bit.
Here, Mark, this should help.
Thanks.
Hey, I'm the one doing all the work
over
here.
Hey, fuck you, cuz.
You didn't think to give me
kiss my ass.
Come on, Larry, give it a
rest. You ain't getting no food neither,
bitch.
Sure,
Lee's getting pretty sick of you thinking he's a danger to the group.
Is that what you told him?
That's right.
Yeah, that's right.
That's right, pussy.
What are you going to do about it?
Look, I don't care what it is, but you two have got to start trying to get along.
They need
the
to give
only
me an
thing
to
I have
him.
To do is protect my daughter. And right now, that means getting this damn wall fixed. So I would appreciate it if you two would shut up and let me get back to work.
I can't wait till he bites it. I swear to God, if I get the chance to leave him, he is not getting saved. I'm definitely going to let him die.
You ever miss the Air Force base? I mean, this wall isn't exactly military standard.
No way I'm going back there. You saw what it was like when you guys picked me up. Completely overrun.
Lily's pretty pissed at us.
Listen, I know her intentions are good, but...
But nothing! She's making the smart choice. Those parasites you guys brought back need to go.
To him. Jesus. Oh my
well,
god.
Good luck with that wall.
I hate talking to him.
We'll get it.
Oh my god. Oh, and I axe him in his fucking back.
You've got to talk to Lily about getting along with Kenny.
Lily can make her own friends.
It's not about making friends. We're all in this together. We gotta start acting like it.
Stuff all that. We'd be fine without you.
Yeah. Keep up on that fence.
Don't tell me what to do, Lee.
I kick him in his fucking balls. I swear to God. Y'all, just know as soon as I get the chance to kill him or leave him, it's being done. Don't expect me to save him. It's not gonna happen, y'all.
How you doing, Clementine?
Okay.
Where's your hat?
I don't know. Can you help me find it?
Sure. When did you lose it?
I had it a couple days ago.
I promise. If I find it, I'll let you know.
Thank you.
Okay, Clem. I've got to take care of some things. Why don't you go back to playing with Duck for a while?
Okay.
Duck. She looked like she, damn, she's all, she looks all distraught. We talked, I saved her for me, so, you know.
Sleeping any better?
No. I know we should be grateful for beds, but no, I'm not.
Drugstore?
Yeah.
She gives a great shot, so she gets food.
Want something to eat?
Plus, she's for me, like I said. I'm gonna give you a piece. I'm gonna give you an apple, girl, because you're my sweet treat.
Have an apple, Carly.
God, I used to eat an apple every morning with some granola and 6 almonds, and that wasn't enough even then. But you know what? Yes.
That's right, girl. You can go ahead.
How you doing, Duck?
I'm okay. Me and Clementine are coloring.
Guess what it is?
I don't know. A dog?
Nope.
Oh, I know. It's a goat, right?
No.
You were pretty brave when we brought those people in here.
That's because I know Mom can fix him.
Catch you later, Duck.
Bye, Lee.
Here, Clem, you need something to eat.
Okay, a sundae would be better next time.
I'll keep that in mind.
If you have any more food, Duck is hungry too.
Yeah, why don't we go get some food?
There's one piece of food left. I'm giving it to the guest.
Some of these people have gone longer than me without food. They're the ones that need it.
Hey, is my friend gonna make it?
I don't know, but Kaja will do her best. I promise.
I can't believe you chopped off his leg.
There was no other way. How you holding up, kid?
I keep wondering if I could have done something to help, you know? Some kind of... I don't know. Something.
I'm sure you did all you could.
Yeah, maybe.
Want something to eat?
Say nothing.
If your camp got raided, probably means you haven't eaten in a while.
I am really hungry. Thanks.
Oh well, so be it. Duck's mom and dad is fat, so they'll be all right.
Not such an easy job, is it?
Nope. Clementine and Duck can share because they're little kids.
I don't envy you. I don't know how you have the strength to do this every day.
I don't have a choice.
So, me and my family don't matter to you anymore?
It's not like that.
You wanted to leave them.
You're out! What happened to my food?
Fuck you.
None left.
You keep treating people
like
this.
Eat a dick.
And your days in this group are numbered.
Hey, you fucked up.
Ken, Lee, come here, please.
And let the kid get bit in the beginning. So fuck you too, cuz.
He lost too much blood.
God damn it. Yeah. I'm getting sick of this shit.
Ken, come back. There's nothing...
Let him go, Kaja.
But...
He just needs time. It's been a rough morning.
That man you brought, I tried, but he was never going to survive.
Well, at least he's not our problem anymore.
What about the other kid?
Oh, shit!
The axe! Hurry!
Oh, shit. What the hell? What the hell? Oh, okay. Yeah, he got me. Oh well. Continue. Oh shit, that's the dude. Oh my god.
Shoot it.
Oh shit.
You okay?
Yeah. Thanks.
Why'd you bring him here in the first place, asshole?
Dad, calm down.
You're gonna get us all killed. Why didn't you tell us he was bitten?
What?
He was bitten, and you didn't say a goddamn word.
But he wasn't bitten, no. I swear.
He just turned.
Your not-bitten friend here came back to life and tried to kill my wife.
What? Wait, you all don't know?
What the hell are you talking about?
It's not the bite that does it.
We've all got it.
You come back no matter how you die. If you don't destroy the brain, that's just what happens. It's gonna happen to all of us.
Infected? Everyone?
I guess so. I don't know. All I know is that I've seen people turn who I know were never bitten. When I first saw it happen, we were all hiding out in a gym and everybody thought we were finally safe. But one of the girls, Jenny Pitcher, I think, I guess she couldn't take it. She took some pills. A lot of them. Someone went in the girls' room the next morning and... God.
Back off!
Whoa, lady, relax. Me and my brother, we just want to know if y'all can help us out.
I said back off, Carly.
Damn, Carly.
We don't want any trouble.
Of course, neither do we. I'm Andy St. John. This here's my brother, Dan. We're just out looking for gasoline. Looks like you folks got the motel locked down, which is fine, but if you could spare any gas, well, we'd be much obliged.
Why do you need gas?
Our place is protected by an electric fence. Generators provide the electricity.
Our generators run on gas. Look, we own a dairy farm a few miles up the road. If y'all be willing to lower your guns, we can talk about some kind of trade.
How y'all doing on food? We got plenty at the dairy.
What's going on over there, then,
baby? Why
don't
you and Mark check the place out? See if it's legit. I'm going with you. I got your back if anything seems fishy.
So, what are y'all thinking?
Yeah, let's go.
You got a deal. We'll bring some gas to your dairy. In exchange, you give us some food to bring back. We'll see how it goes from there.
Sounds fair. A couple gallons should power one of our generators for a while.
Mm-hmm. I'm actually trying to work with Lucky right now. And
sure do. We lost most of the cattle.
Go to the bathroom.
We still have lots of milk, butter, and cheese stocked up.
And with the vegetables we grow, we got plenty of food.
Yep, he went.
It's nice to get away from that motel for a while. This Lily Kenny thing is starting to get ridiculous. Personally, I'd be happier if you started to take charge more.
I got you, buddy. I got you. Wait, hold on.
You think they'd want me for a leader?
Sure. Everybody looks up to you.
Well, not everyone thinks I'm so trustworthy.
I'm sorry, buddy.
Because of your past. Does anyone else know?
Doesn't matter.
You've got to let go of that guilt. The Lee I know is a good man.
Clementine might know. She was there when we were talking in the drugstore and asked me about it. I lied to her, but...
What exactly did happen with the senator?
You know what happened.
I only know what the press was told. I don't know your story.
Sometimes I wonder if I should talk to the group about it.
You don't have to. Whatever happened before things went to hell doesn't matter anymore.
Not sure everyone would see it that way.
Maybe you're right. Listen, over the years, I've reported on some pretty messed up shit. I've seen situations like yours 100 times. It doesn't have to make you a bad man.
I really appreciate that.
I mean, thank God Lee showed up when he did. Right, Lee?
Yeah, why don't you tell us a little more about yourself, Lee?
Where are you from?
I grew up in Macon.
Right here in the heart of Georgia. That's what I like to hear. Y'all seem pretty settled in at that motor inn. Who's running things over there?
I am. You guys have any questions? You come to me.
How many
yeah.
people you got
took
over
charge,
there
you
anyway?
See that?
9, including the kids.
You forgot Ben.
Me?
That makes it 10.
Well, we'd love to get you all out to the dairy. Like I said, we got plenty of food, and quite frankly, we could always use an extra helping hand.
In the summers, I used to help out on a goat farm.
Yeah, that's great. Everything helps.
Mama's been running the dairy for as long as I can remember.
He's settled now.
Now it's...
You think you're going to cut me out of this?
Shit, get down.
No one's trying to cut you out of anything.
You and Gary are always putting this...
Bandits? Who? Those look like the people who raided my camp. Who are they?
Uh-oh. Fuck you. Fucking you knew we were hungry. And you guys were keeping it
there's
off
only
yourself.
Two of them.
Yeah, you know what? More. We ate it all. What are you
gonna
fucking do about it?
Don't worry. Danny and I got you covered if something happens, but let's just wait this out. Hope they move on.
Fuck you!
Damn.
Fuck you!
Wow.
Jesus.
Wow.
The world out here has gone to shit. Come on. Mm-hmm. Let's get to the dairy where it's safe.
Wow. He just shot him in the body. Here's Daryl's crossbow. Get it. Give it back to Daryl.
Here it is. St. John Family Dairy. Y'all can see how we kept this place so safe.
The fence keeps them out?
You betcha. They fry like
electric
bugs in a zapper. We're pushing 4,000 volts through that thing with generators and amps.
I'm going to assume that's a lot.
This is a really brilliant setup.
Suits us just fine.
This place looks untouched. You'd never know the rest of the world is in ruins.
It's worth protecting. Hence all the juice.
I thought I saw y'all with company coming down the drive.
Guys, this is our mama.
I'm Brenda St. John, and welcome to the St. John Dairy.
This here's Lee. He's from Macon.
A couple of our old farmhands were from Macon. They grow them good there.
They got a few more friends staying at the old motel.
Oh, my goodness. That place is pretty vulnerable. Have you got someone with survival experience to lead your group?
We all work together. Plus, we've got plenty of people with military experience.
Well, that's good to hear. That motel ain't the safest place.
Hold on. I thought you said someone else was running things.
Oh, yeah. I thought she was asking about survival tactics.
Well, it don't matter. You're here now. We'll make sure you're safe and comfortable.
Does that offer apply to the rest of us?
We're all incredibly hungry.
These are for y'all. Baked fresh this morning.
Amazing.
Can't get stuff like that anymore.
I want some.
Without a cow for milk and butter, that's for sure.
That's right. Hopefully Maybelle will make it through this bout of whatever she's got and be with us for a good long while.
Your cow is sick? What's she...
We have a vet. We could bring her here. We can help you folks out.
A vet? Oh, my. Our prayers have been answered.
Maybe our whole group could come for the day.
Well, how about this? Y'all go get your veterinary friend, and I'll prepare some dinner. A big feast for all you hungry souls.
That's what I'm talking about.
It'd be nice to have some folks to help out around here again.
Southern hospitality.
Why don't I head back with the food and round up everyone for the trip over here?
Might want to take someone with you. Remember, those roads can be dangerous.
I can handle myself.
Take this. Why don't you go ahead and take Ben along anyway?
Take care of yourself, Lee. See you in a while.
Mark, Lee, why don't you take a look around? Once you get settled in, I could use some help securing the perimeter.
Is there a problem?
Sometimes the dead get tangled up in the fence before they fry and end up knocking over a post. It'd be a big help if you could walk the perimeter. You can learn a little something about our fence. I'm gonna go top off the generators before they run dry. Come get me when you're ready.
You betcha. This place is incredible. It's got food. And that fence?
Utopia.
Man, that fence. If we play our cards right, this might turn out to be a place we can stay.
Like they eat people. How do you want to play this?
Before we can think about bringing our whole group here to stay, we need to figure out if this place is as safe as they're telling us.
Right. Obviously, they think it's safe. But is it safe enough for the kids? I noticed a broken swing over there. Not a big deal, but maybe there's other things not working that we just can't see yet.
And checking the fence perimeter sounds like a decent way to get a good look at their defenses.
All right. I'll keep my eyes open, and you find out what you can from Andy.
Ready.
Too bad it's broken. I'll bet Clementine and Duck would have loved something like this to play on.
Kids used to like that old swing even more than the tour sometimes.
I'll bet. How'd it break?
Got busted the first day those things showed up. Thank God no one was on it at the time.
Looks like it just needs a new board for the seat and some rope. Make it safe for Clem and Duck. And let the St. Johns know we can pull our weight around here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna need some rope. And there's got to be a board around here I can use as a seat. Hmm. too big right now, but if I can find something to cut it down to size, this might make a good seat for the swing. Mind if I use one of these boards?
Already making some repairs, huh? I like a guy who takes some initiative. Yeah, go right ahead.
You just put that in your damn back pocket.
Looks like the fence runs around the entire property, not just the house.
Yep, can't take any chances when it comes to safety. Glad you guys decided to help us out. I noticed back at the motel that you folks are pretty well armed. You've been stockpiling, huh?
Yeah, if you need some extra people to protect the dairy, you can count on us.
Well, hopefully it'll never come to that, but thanks.
We can't be the first people you've invited up to the dairy.
Well, no, we've made similar deals with other folks, trading for gas and food, but ultimately they moved on, looking for the people they lost contact with.
An electric fence is enough to keep out walkers?
Walkers? Is that what you call them? That's good. The old one wouldn't have, but Mac, he was our foreman, he figured out how to amp it up with the generator. We used to sit out here some nights and watch the sons of bitches sizzling pop when they got too close. Closest thing to entertainment these days, I guess.
These generators are enough to power the whole dairy?
We got lots. We gotta keep trading for fuel as much as we can, but they all work together to do the trick. Like us.
Mark and I can help you with that perimeter now.
Oh, good. The fence will stop a walker in about 3 or 4 seconds, but it's overloaded if we leave the husks out there.
You know, Mark and I can clear the fence ourselves if you want to stay here and finish up with the generators.
Well, that'd be great. I'll turn off the northwest section, and if you guys could strip them off and look for any weak points, well, that'd be a big help.
Sounds easy enough.
Stay attentive. You never know.
So how's the place looking? Is it safe enough for us to stay? If we can?
It's pretty amazing what they've done with this dairy, but let's see what it takes to secure this fence before drawing any conclusions.
I can't wait until everyone's out here. Everyone besides Larry.
What's up with you telling him what I said about him thinking I'm dangerous?
Look, you said it. You even admitted it right to him.
That guy's a piece of shit anyway.
Yeah,
relax. You're not making things any better riling him up.
Fuck him.
There's one. Ugh. Lee, it's dead.
Come on, let's push it off.
Who do you think he was?
Maybe a farmhand. I don't know. I hope he wasn't like this long before the fence finished him off.
Yeah.
Looks like he's stuck. Maybe the St. John boys are using this guy for target practice?
Poor guy.
I don't know what got him first, the arrow or the fence. Either way, hope he was already dead. Disgusting. Come on, I'm sure there's still a few more.
Once this fence is patched up, this place will be a fortress. God, can you imagine not having to worry about the walkers anymore?
The fortress needs people to defend it.
We've got enough people. So what's your take on the brothers? They seem to have this place tied down pretty well.
What do you mean by that?
I don't know. They seem decent enough. I just want you to know that I've got your back if anything goes down. That's all.
Thanks. There's another one.
I see it.
Any surprises?
Man, the fence burned right into its hands. I think they fused together.
You never get used to the smell, do you?
Nope.
Christ. I can't stop thinking about dinner. Thanks for the rations earlier. It's not easy eating in front of the kids.
You brought us more food.
It's all that's keeping me on my feet right now.
We'll go ask for more to eat after this is done.
Alright, I can suck it up. Come on, I think I see where they're getting in. This one must have knocked it over trying to get through. He's tangled up in there pretty good. Come on, help me get this thing back in place so we can get Mr. Crispy off of here.
I think we'd get better leverage from the other side.
Good idea.
What is going to happen?
If you're waiting for that guy to help, it ain't gonna happen. Come on. A little help here, Lee? Holy fuck!
I knew
what
it.
Happened?
The fences are
it.
On.
I
Why the
it.
Hell would he turn the fence on?
I
he knows we're out here.
Knew it. I fucking knew it.
What the? Get to the gate! Get down!
I fucking knew it.
We had an agreement! Now you're fucked!
Who the fuck is that?
No idea!
Fuck! Now what?
With the fence on that gate, it's our only way out!
Well, maybe they turned it on because those guys were coming.
Did you really think you were fucking that?
Can't hide forever!
I already got one of you!
Please, go ahead.
Deliver the goods!
The place is stuck in the dirt.
Take what's due! Behind the tractor!
Oh, you got me.
Please!
You are dead.
Holy fuck! What just happened?
The fences are on.
Why the hell would he turn the fence on? He knows we're out here.
Hey, you just start from right where it's...
Get to the gate! Get down!
You asshole! Jesus! We had an agreement! Now you're fucked!
Who the fuck is that?
No idea!
Fuck! Now what?
With the fence on that gate, it's our only way out!
Can't hide forever! What about all the rain?
Are you really thinking about that?
Okay. Okay. I already got one of you. Behind the tractor! I got you now!
Yeah.
Come on. We can reach the gate. We can get through this fence and back to the house.
Ah! Shit, that hurts.
Got a little bit of you out there.
Punk motherfuckers.
Damn. You assholes!
This was the last of...
What happened?
Fuck.
It's one of the dead we pushed down earlier. Gonna have to move it.
I see ya.
All right.
Show yourself. Get closer, you idiot.
They got a lot of damn arrows, don't they? Really?
How many of those things really? Down?
Really? Enough for one? Oh no.
Come on, the gate's right there.
Give us the food. We're getting away.
Let's get out of here.
You lucky sons of bitches. Go ahead and run. We ain't going nowhere.
We had a deal, huh?
Lee, what's wrong?
I thought this place was safe.
Holy shit, are you okay?
Fucking bandits. They have no right being out here.
Oh, my lord! What happened to you, sweetheart?
It was those bastards in the woods, Mama.
Yeah, I'll be all right once it's out. God damn, it hurts.
Hey, y'all.
Mark, oh my god, what happened?
He got shot with an arrow.
Christ, are you gonna be okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I should just pull it out.
Oh, no, honey, come on. Brenda's got you. Come on inside now. We'll have you all sorted out. Well. You must be the
what kind of shit is this?
Here we ran go. Into some people on the way up here. Bandits, I guess. I think it was them that attacked us.
They gave us a lot of problems in the beginning. Killed a bunch of our farmhand. We were able to get them to stop by making a deal.
You knew about these people?
Food for protection. Not like we had much of a choice, but they did stop hassling us.
God damn it. Carly said this place was locked down tight.
Maybe it isn't as safe here as we thought.
Look, we're sorry. We never had them screw with us like this. Not since we started giving them food. Listen, we may have had an agreement with those people, but we will not stand for this shit.
Ain't no way we're gonna let those sons of bitches get away with this.
You know where these assholes are?
They're hard to pin down, but I think I know where at least one of their camps are. When you're ready to go scope out that bandit camp, come find us.
Bandits? Are you serious? This place isn't safe. We can't stay here.
Not safe? This place is a hell of a lot safer than that motor inn. I think all of us and our guns can handle a couple of punks with bows and arrows. What we need to do is find a way to get our whole group out here to stay. Take this place over if we have to.
Whoa, cool your jets there, Rambo. These are nice people. Let's not do anything to get us thrown out before we eat.
I'm gonna head out and help Dan deal with these bandits. You guys should try to make friends with Andy and Brenda while I'm gone.
Well, that's easy. I got charm coming out of my ass.
Yeah, that's real charming, Dad.
Where's Ben and Carly?
Since Carly and Ben ate some of the food on the way to get us, she volunteered to stay behind and watch the motor in until we get back.
Hey, I remember seeing kids in your group, so I went ahead and fixed that swing while you were out. I hope you kids like swings.
A swing! I love swings! Just like at my treehouse. Come on, Doc.
Why don't you kids go and play on the swing, huh?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Anytime. We're looking out for you.
That thing keeps a fence electrified.
Yes, it does.
That thing keeps a fence electrified. definitely tell they built this thing themselves. They're storing gasoline all over the property. No mail coming in or out these days. At least they don't have to worry about bill collectors anymore.
The hell? Oh. Like...
Hey, Clem, do you like the swing?
Yeah, it's fun.
Be sure to tell Andy thank you, okay?
I will. Will you push me on it?
Of course.
Sure. Happy to push you on the swing. Mind if Clementine takes a turn?
All right, Duck. Let Clementine have a try for a bit.
Okay.
Did that old martial arts flip off of it.
What do you think of the dairy?
It's pretty. It reminds me of how things used to look before.
Yeah, it does.
Do you think things will ever get back to how they were?
Not sure, Clint. I hope so.
I hope so, too.
How you holding up, Clementine?
I'm okay, I guess. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm just a little worried about Mark.
Is Mark going to be okay?
You're lucky out there. Could have been a lot worse.
Are you going to find the people who hurt Mark?
Well, we have to make sure they don't hurt anyone else.
Be careful. I want you to stay lucky, too.
Ever since I met you, I've had good luck, so don't worry.
Okay.
All right, Clem, that's enough for now.
Okay, thanks for pushing me.
Of course, it's all yours.
Yeah!
Okay, Duck, don't pop a gasket.
They look happy.
It was in the fucking barn. Wait a minute.
I guess Mark and I were lucky we weren't touching this thing when it came on.
Remember in the last thing, they had motherfuckers in the barn.
Looks like a feeding station for the cow. Having a crop like that on hand must be great. We're gonna need to learn how to maintain it if we end up staying here.
Damn right, I'm gonna open that door. See if y'all hiding anything in that bitch.
Lots of hay. Enough of these might work as adequate cover from arrows, if that becomes a problem. Free tours. I doubt these people give anything away for free now. If there's not enough room in the house for all of us, I guess a few of us could camp out here in shifts. If there's not enough room in the
Why
house
they open
for all
it?
Of us, I guess a few of us could camp out here in shifts.
Thank you.
Lee, oh my god, I'm so glad you two didn't get killed out there. Do you think Mark will be okay?
Wish I knew, but I think he's in good hands now.
Yeah? It's not too bad?
He'll be fine. I've seen guys go through worse.
How could you all bring us to this place?
How do you feel about leaving the motor in?
It's a welcome change of scenery.
I don't know. If we'd just stayed where we were, then Mark wouldn't have ended up with an arrow in his shoulder.
So?
I take it you and Kenny didn't exactly make up on the way here.
I tried seeing things from his point of view, having a wife and kid and everything.
Now.
But gambling with your family's life is pretty stupid if you ask me. Lee, I know you and Kenny are friends, but you recognize that he's not the right person to lead this group, don't you?
You're a good leader, Lily. Kenny's too emotional, but his intentions are in the right place. Still, it'd be best for all of us if you two could try to work together once in a while. Quaint. Doesn't offer much in the way of protection, though. Fucking fence came on again. How you feeling, Lee?
Look, I'm really sorry you almost got killed out there. We should have told you how dangerous it was.
No shit.
You saw what they did to your buddy. Nobody's safe here until we start to fight back.
But how?
The two of us should go out and do some recon. Then we'll all mount up for some revenge.
Hell yeah.
Who the fuck are these people in the woods?
We don't know.
You're mad real fast.
Some of them used to work at the big box up the way.
Save lots.
Yeah. Anyway, they're nutty as all hell and get mad when they're hungry.
So, are you ready to head out there and find their camp?
Yeah.
We'll go in a few minutes. Just need to check on a few things before we head out.
Sure, that's understandable. Talk things over with your group. Just come find us when you're ready.
I'll do that.
Anything interesting?
I'm just trying to make sure this place is secure, in case we decide to make this a more long-term solution. Except for those people in the woods. Seems pretty safe.
Good to know. Keep your ears open for anything else that might help us.
I guess, Lily isn't too thrilled about being here.
I could give two shits about what Lily wants. Duck and Katja need food, and I'm not about to sit around that motor inn and watch him go hungry. You're with me on this, right?
You're not making me pick sides, Kenny.
Well, you better think about it, because that time is coming.
Yeah.
Did Duck and Katja get here okay?
No, it wasn't easy. Duck didn't look so good on the walk over to this place.
Well, if everything works out, maybe he and Katja can have an easier life here.
That's funny, considering you didn't seem too worried about Duck back at Herschel's farm.
That's in the past, Kenny. Lots happened since then.
Yeah, right.
The fuck is wrong with him?
I'm gonna go have a look around.
Don't wait too long to help scope out that bandit camp. It'd be a good opportunity to find out a bit more about the St. Johns and their relationship with those bandits or whatever.
Right. See what I can find out.
Hey, Lee.
Change your mind about going out to track down them bandits?
Yeah, it'll be a good opportunity to find out a bit more about what we're up against. Let's do it.
I'll stay here and hold down the fort.
Remember, we're just doing reconnaissance for now. No use getting ourselves killed.
Lee, where are you going?
Are you going now?
Yeah, I'll be back soon, Clementine.
Please be lucky.
I will.
See anything?
Not yet.
I know it's around here. It's gotta be close.
Here.
Oh shit, you found it? See anybody?
Stay on your guard.
Watch my back, Lee. I'm gonna check out the tent.
The jump scare.
This camp's too small. It can't be their main base.
That's what I was thinking.
Take a look around anyway. There's probably some shit around here they stole from us.
Empty. Nothing. Looks like they expected to be here a while. Just water.
No.
Tent looks pretty new. Anybody inside?
Two sleeping bags. One of them's kid-sized.
Looks like they were moving a lot of stuff.
No.
Tent looks pretty new. Anybody inside?
Two sleeping bags. One of them's kid-sized. What's in the boxes?
They're all from Save Lots.
The first few days, they told folks to gather to the Save Lots by the interstate. Anything worth taking?
We don't know whose camp this is. Might not be bandits.
It must be. They don't share their neighborhood.
Boxes from the dairy here.
Probably food we've been giving them.
Uh-oh.
Fresh cross the line.
What do you find?
A video camera.
Let me see that.
Battery's dead, though.
Oh, good. What else they got over here?
Oh,
let's see if we can find anything useful and then get a move on.
Something is wrong.
I see you handled that gun I lent you pretty well. You a hunter?
No, but Lily keeps us all on a regular training schedule.
Lily? I thought you were running things back there.
Yeah, but she's got the combat training. Empty. But it looks like someone's been eating out of these. Recently. Yuck. I don't need that. Nothing but fumes. Shit.
Wait a minute. Uh-oh.
The hell?
Don't fucking move!
Shit!
Put your guns down.
I ain't going back. You tell him Jolene ain't going back.
Jolene.
Hey, we had a deal. No shooting as long as we gave you food. What the fuck happened?
You had a deal with them. I ain't them. Oh, I know you. I know what you are. And I know what you do.
You don't know me.
Steal my shit. Steal everything from me.
We had a deal. You people broke it first.
We're looking for the people who attacked the dairy and shot my friend.
I don't know where they are, but they ain't here. So get the fuck out of my camp.
She's lying, Lee.
Now maybe you didn't hear me last time. When I asked you, sweet, put your damn guns down. You think I won't kill you? I'm gonna take this here crossbow and put a nice sharp arrow right through your eyeball. Into your goddamn brain. You're not men. You're monsters. All men are monsters. Take what they want and then destroy it all. Take a can of beans. Take a little girl. It's all the fucking same to you.
Where did you get this hat?
The little girl.
You stole it from her.
So what if I did? You stole her from me.
What?
What the hell are you talking about?
You know what? I changed my mind. I'm putting this arrow right through your balls. Yeah, right through.
What?
String them up on that tree.
Oh,
then I'm gonna head down to that farm and shoot every goddamn person I see.
Look, there's two of us and one of you. No matter what happens, one of us is gonna kill you.
Like you could kill me. They couldn't kill me. They tried. Killing everyone.
He gonna
Take
shoot
all
her.
The dead folks you want. We'll make more. Go on. Tell him, boy. Tell him what you got in mind for.
I knew it. Something's up with him. Something's up with him.
God damn it!
You straight up murdered that woman!
Hardly. She had a crossbow pointed at my forehead. It's a clean shot, though. Right through the forehead.
That's good shooting right there. Still, what a waste.
You got a problem.
So, that's it. We going back?
If they ain't here, I don't know where they are. And it ain't a good idea to go tromping through the woods looking for them. So yeah, we head back. Once they see this, they'll get the message.
Something is not right.
Come on.
I knew it. Find some batteries for that camera. Look at that.
That was a hell of a ride, huh?
Jesus, Danny.
What? You ain't getting soft on them, are you? Not after what they did to your friend.
You're back. What happened?
Handled it, Mama.
This isn't what Terry would have wanted.
Terry?
My husband. Miss him every day.
Then screw it up for everybody then, why don't you?
Oh, calm down, Princess. I'll do it myself.
What's going on with them?
Dunno. Squabbling, looks like. A lot of tension with y'all, huh?
Yeah, you could say that. They don't exactly see eye to eye on how we should be doing things.
Well, it's probably just the hunger talking. And Lee,
not really.
Don't worry your head about them bandits. I'm sorry you've seen more violence than I'd have thought in your short time, but you all are safe here. Don't worry.
Think I'll go have a look around.
Don't wander too far. Dinner will be ready before you know it. And thank your friend Koch again for me. She and the kids are in the barn with the cow. That woman is a lifesaver.
He went real crazy about the hat, didn't he?
You stole it!
Sorry, boy. I didn't mean to wake you up.
It's okay, Clementine. You can pet her.
It's okay. Go ahead.
Whoa. Katya says Mabel could have her baby tonight.
We'll see, Clementine.
What's this thing?
Daddy said it's called a salt lick.
Yeah, but don't lick it. It's gross.
Did you lick it?
I don't know.
I don't know.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
We met this woman up in the woods. She seemed to know your brother.
He probably talks a little more than he ought to.
How's the cow?
Well, better now we got Doc on the case.
When do you think, we might eat?
Hungry, huh? Don't worry. Mama's cooking up some good grub.
Thanks.
Yep.
She looks skinny.
Here, Clementine.
My hat! You found it! I knew you'd find it. You said you would.
Listen, did you give your hat to anyone?
No.
Did you see any strangers around the motor inn who might have taken it?
No. Why?
It's probably nothing. Just let me know if you ever see anything like that.
Okay, I will. Hey, Lee, do you think you'll ever have kids?
I'd like to someday. Maybe a little girl like you.
That's nice. You'd be a good daddy. Well, thanks for finding my hat.
You're welcome, Clem.
Do you want to pet the cow with me?
Nah, but you go on ahead.
Just looking at shit, huh? Okay.
I want to play in the hay.
Just stay close to your mom for now.
Okay. I want to play in the hay.
Okay.
Just stay close to your mom for now.
Okay.
I thought he was going to, like, make another examination. Observe something. Yeah, what's up in these boxes?
Empty. Looks like a bunch of old dirty clothes. Ooh, smells pretty foul. Looks like a bunch of old dirty clothes. Ooh, smells pretty foul. It's a feeding trough. It's a feeding trough. Just some fence posts.
Found it too, huh? Lee, they're hiding something behind this door. I got a quick look. They got boxes of stuff and something metal and sharp.
Don't get paranoid.
It's my job to be paranoid, Lee. I got my whole family on this farm right now. How about you? What about Clem?
They eating motherfuckers.
I'll protect her no matter what.
I know you will. Look. That guy with Katya, what's his name? He locked it up real tight the second we came in. I definitely heard a noise back there, Lee.
What?
My point is, we gotta know for sure. So go find a hammer or something, and I'll have this thing off in a second.
They eat people.
You back me up in case them farmers come running.
Hang on, man. Think this through. You smash the lock, Then what if it turns out you're wrong? You just fucked your chance to get a good meal on those kids you're trying to protect. Use your head, Kenny.
All right, Professor, what'd you have in mind?
Let me have a look at what we're dealing with first.
Hey, Lee, you know how to pick a lock, right?
No! Why would you say that?
Well, you're, you know...
criminal.
Urban?
Oh,
my
you are
God.
Not saying what I think you're saying.
Jesus
man,
Christ.
I'm from Florida. Crazy shit just comes out of my mouth sometimes. Sorry.
Racist motherfucker.
Hmm.
What?
See those screws? Instead of breaking the padlock, we can just take off the assembly, have a peek inside, and then replace it all again like nothing ever happened.
All right. Sounds like you got a plan. I'll hang around and keep an eye on that guy with the cow.
Andy.
Shit, I thought that was Danny. Whatever.
Can I help you boys find something?
Just checking out the barn here. Never been to a dairy farm before.
Just don't roam around without me or Danny. The farm can be a dangerous place.
Yeah, my
you know,
God.
Bandits and all. Sorry about your friend. Hey, do me a favor. Don't fuck around with this door, okay? Just, you know, Mama gets nervous.
Andrew, I need your help again.
No problem. Right away, Doc. Hey, guys, seriously, don't fuck around with that. Come on, enough already.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
Danny mentioned he needed something.
Did he say what?
Shit, I can't remember now. Sorry.
All right, all right. Be right back, Doc.
Okay, let's do this.
False alarm. I'm back.
God damn it.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
You got a screwdriver?
For what?
Never mind. Danny needs something again.
All right, all right. Yeah. Be right back, Doc.
Let's do this.
False alarm.
God damn it.
I tried distracting Andy, but he keeps coming back.
There's got to be something out there you can mess with to keep him busy for a while. What about those generators?
A woman like yourself
oh,
run
Lord.
This whole place.
Oh, I managed just fine. Plus, I had my boys to help out. I couldn't do it without them.
Switch.
Damn, this thing is the worst piece of shit. Something's always tripping the breaker.
God damn it, man.
I guess Mark and I were lucky we weren't touching this thing when it came up.
Guess I gotta ask him.
Probably just need a screwdriver or something.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
Why do you lock that door?
Because we can't afford to lose our shit to the people in the woods. They come down here every once in a while, raid our stuff. Even with the fence. Alrighty then.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah?
Alrighty then.
I tried distracting Andy, but he keeps coming back.
There's gotta be something out there you can mess with to keep him busy for a while.
Hey guys, seriously, don't fuck around with
this
that.
Game is
come on,
so slow moving that, like, you know, making the same choices over and over is just not good.
Have I missed anything?
No, not really. It smells funny in here.
Like manure.
What's manure?
Duty.
Kids.
So I already fucked with the generator twice.
Lots of hay. Enough of these might work as adequate cover from arrows, if that becomes a problem.
What's going on, Lee? Did something happen?
Kenny thinks they're hiding something. I'm not sure what exactly, but we're starting to get a feeling about this place. I don't know. Maybe we should go have a look in that barn.
Whatever you do, just be careful.
It's been 3 months. Your dad still treats me like I'm some kind of asshole.
Yeah, well, don't expect that to change. That's just how he is.
How do you put up with it?
Look, my dad can be an ass sometimes, I know that. But he's not a bad guy. He's got a lot of pain. He's been through so much, and lost pretty much everything. And it's hardened him, you know? Yeah, he's bitter and hateful, but that's all just to protect himself. Mm-hmm. And me. All he's got left in the world is me. And that goes both ways. So yeah, he's probably gonna keep treating you like crap, but that's just because he still has one thing left to care about. So don't judge him. And don't judge me for sticking by him. He's my dad. And I love him.
What were you and Kenny arguing about when I came back from the camp?
He's losing it, Lee. He comes over and starts talking about searching the barn and that these people are hiding something. The way I see it, we just need to skip the dinner and get our food to go. But I'm starting to think your friend over there has another agenda.
After what Kenny told me, I'm starting to think they may be trying to hide something.
You two are just asking for trouble. But if you insist on wandering around, I'd be careful, Lee.
I'm gonna go check things out.
Watch yourself, Lee.
Screwdriver.
I'm just gonna borrow this for a second.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah.
So, where do you keep the rest of the tools?
Well, if you need something, just tell me what it is, and I can get it for you.
Not that important.
Alrighty then.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah.
Alrighty then.
God damn it.
Picked up something I think could help with the lock.
All right, good to hear.
Hey there, Andy.
Yeah.
Alrighty then. Hey guys, seriously, don't
come
fuck
on,
around.
Man.
Come on, enough already.
I tried distracting Andy, but he keeps coming back.
So I tried to turn off the generator again.
There, you can mess with to keep him busy for a
while. Again. Okay. Jesus. Yeah, I should have got it turned off the generator and then came in. That's probably what I should have did. Word. Come on. What the fuck, y'all?
switch.
We'll finish talking later.
You been getting along with Larry?
He's just a big old sweetheart, ain't he?
Nope.
Don't know if I would have used those words exactly.
Don't judge, honey. This world is bringing out the worst in people. But if you really look, you'll catch a glimpse of humanity every now and then.
So, what are y'all keeping the barn back there? Besides cows, I mean.
Well, someone's getting a little curious, aren't they?
I don't mean to pry.
It's nothing interesting, I can promise you that much. Just some odds and ends. Takes a lot to run a farm, you know.
How's Mark doing in there?
Best patient I ever had. Oh, my boys get so much as a scratch and start hollering. He can definitely teach them a thing or two about being tough.
I'd still like to check on him.
You're gonna have to trust me on this, Lee. I've helped stitch my share of wounds. I know what I'm talking about.
We ran into some trouble out there.
I was just glad you two weren't hurt. Those bandits just don't know when to quit. But my boys, they can hold their own.
Before she died, we met a woman out there at her camp. She wasn't one of those bandits. Sounded like they did something pretty bad to her. And your marauders are still out there.
I think all them folks out in the woods had drug problems.
What does that have to do with anything?
Means you can't trust them. Any of them.
Think I'll go have a look around.
Kinda peaceful out here, ain't it? Enjoy it while you can. You'll probably start hearing those monsters frying against the fence before too long.
Hello. Glad I got to use her today. My girl here.
It's the wheelbarrow.
I saw a wheelbarrow over there full of garbage. Some bloody clothes.
Things happen on a dairy. Cut myself darn bad just the other day. Blood everywhere.
You seem okay.
I'm tough.
How do you run this place with just one cow?
Used to have more. They get hungry too. Or sick. Got your doctor friend here now, though.
You guys must trade for a lot of fuel to keep the generators running, right?
People get hungry, and a few loaves of bread fetch a high price. Y'all are luckier on this side of the deal now.
You really like that gun.
What's not to like?
Just kinda creepy, that's all.
Times like these, a 243 will keep you warmer at night than any lady I ever known.
I'll go wait for supper then.
It'll be a that's good fine. One.
I wanna kill him.
All fixed. That should make everyone happy.
Ah. Maybe that'll help.
Doesn't look very safe, but I guess that's the point.
I see you're watching the chat. What the fuck am I supposed to do, huh? Fuck, y'all. Oh, my God. Well.
Looks like a feeding station for the cow. Hey there, Andy.
Yeah. Alrighty then.
That's it. I ain't got no options, huh? Come on, man.
I tried distracting Andy, but he keeps coming
back. There's gotta be something out there you can mess with to keep him busy for a while.
Empty.
Hey guys, seriously, don't fuck around with that. Come on, enough already.
Looks like a bunch of old dirty clothes. Ooh, smells pretty foul.
Well, I got a contact in the chat with y'all, and they're saying look at the generator. That everyone's saying look at the generator. I already did. What the fuck else do I gotta do to it, y'all? Jesus Christ! Cause this game moves slow, man. This is not the game you wanna like. You know, fuck around with like that. Makes it boring.
I'm glad Andy knows how to fix this if something goes wrong. I'm clueless about this stuff.
Okay.
Power switch.
Okay.
Power switch.
The yellow part? Okay. Okay, I was wondering if I had to cut a wire. If you noticed earlier, I did look at that, but nothing lit the fuck up.
I'm glad Andy knows how to fix this if something goes wrong. I'm clueless about this stuff.
See? Fucking oh. I thought it was the yellow wire. Hey. Thanks, y'all. Appreciate it. Thanks, contact on the outside.
Looks like that belt's driving the whatchamacallit.
So it's cutting.
Ow! Damn it! Thing is moving fast.
Thank you.
There, that should do it.
Fucking Danny, where'd he find this piece of shit?
After
thing threw a bell.
Fucking
Damn
half hour.
Oh, son of a fuck! Oh, this take forever.
Fucking shit. Thank you. I owe you. Got a contact on the outside in the chat with you savages. Now let's get it. I wonder what's in there. Hurry back.
Mom, Dad, dinner time! It's dinner time!
Okay, honey, let's get that.
Dad! Dad! Come on! Let's eat!
Kenny, come along, honey. Kenny, come on. Don't make the children wait.
I'll make an excuse for you. Get that thing off.
Baby, baby! This is going to be interesting.
You got in that back room.
Look, we have food here, but Danny and I still gotta do a lot of hunting to keep everyone fed. When we catch something in the woods, we skin it and dress it back there. Mama doesn't like us to make a mess in the house, so you see, nothing to worry about.
Oh no. Monsters. What are we eating? Oh, man.
Brenda, you are an angel.
Excuse the mess. We had to block the back door after Walker got upstairs. Don't worry. That was a while ago, and I ain't been back inside since.
Everybody sit down. Now go get the meal. Oh, this is a delight.
I could eat a horse.
Where's Mark?
Now don't you worry about him. I've already brought some food up. You just let him rest.
Oh, my God.
I gotta wash my hands first.
Bathroom's right outside in the hall. And be sure to get under your nails. You've been mucking around in the dirt all day.
Oh, no. Oh, my God. Fuck that. Scratches. Oh, fuck. Did they drag him back there?
This dairy must have meant a lot to them before the Walkers destroyed everything. Andy's college degree. These boys aren't stupid. Andy's baseball trophy. Seems like it's been years since kids were playing sports for fun. Walkers aren't getting through that thing.
Look at his face. Look at his eyes. Oh my God. They fucking ate my homeboy.
Musty as hell. candles. Smart. I guess someone needed some first aid recently. Ugh, what is this stuff? Looks like a bunch of medical waste in here. IV tubes, saline. What would dairy farmers need with this kind of stuff? Huh, where is that cord going?
Yeah, that's what I'm wondering.
What the hell?
Right. Fuck is this?
Where the hell is Mark? But Brenda said he was up here resting.
Man, this motherfucker is in pieces.
Is that blood?
God damn. They cooked his ass.
Farm books, cookbooks. Nothing out of the ordinary here.
That's like a line. That's like a line from a scary movie that everyone will remember. Don't eat dinner. Oh, God.
Spit that out!
Lee, what's going on?
Lee, Jesus, man. Did you find something? Oh, sit your ass down, Lee. This lady has made you a meal.
Yeah, Lee. What's gotten into
everybody's
you?
Everybody's eating.
He just can't stop.
He could use some goddamn manners.
You're eating human meat.
That's crazy.
What the hell? I'm scaring the kids, Lee.
Lee, what the hell is wrong with you?
Don't indulge him, Lily. There's always something with this guy.
Mom, I was eating that.
What is going on?
Go upstairs and look. You'll find a guy with both of his legs hacked off. This is a dairy, not a ranch. Think about it.
Wow.
Everything could have turned out okay for you folks.
He would have died anyway. We gotta think about living.
Settle down, honey. Growing up in rural Georgia, you're taught not to waste. It's how I was raised and how I raised my boss.
God.
Now, you got monsters roaming around that do nothing but eat people. And for what? To continue to rot till they eat some more. We think we can put that meat to better use.
Oh, I'm gonna puke.
You're all sick. Sick in the head.
Lee, that's not a very nice thing to imply.
Damn right I chose to be direct.
Andy is right. We go after folks who were gonna die anyways. One way or
he wasn't gonna die. He just had an arrow on his shoulder. Like y'all, shit.
Clementine, run!
Nobody's going anywhere.
We got lots of use for y'all right here.
What the fuck? The fucking black.
Put your guns down. We're walking out of here.
Come here, my fucking family.
I don't want to die, mommy. What did I eat?
Everyone. Everything will be okay!
Lee? Lee?
Fuck.
Let go of her, you son of a bitch!
Damn, how we get out of here?
Please.
Open the goddamn door! You can't keep us in here!
Second time he got knocked out.
I will tear you fuckers apart with my bare hands!
We gotta find another way out of here.
Yo, sick fucking bastards! Open this door, goddammit! I will knock the goddamn door down!
It was a person. I ate meat from a person. Does that mean I'm gonna turn into...
No, Clem, it doesn't work like that.
If he would have stopped us in time...
Come on, Dad. Now's not the time.
Shut the fuck up.
You okay, Clementine? They didn't hurt you, did they?
Mm-mm.
Open up!
Lee, those psychos have my family, and we're stuck in a damn meat locker. We gotta get the fuck out of here!
This goddamn thumbsucker was the one who brought us here!
Will you all just shut the fuck up?
I'm scared.
Don't be. It's gonna be okay. I'm gonna find us a way out of here.
You're worse than the walkers!
Dad, please! Please, settle down!
I'll rip your goddamn heads off and make you swallow them!
Come on, Larry. Do you really want to attract their attention?
Yeah, I want to attract their attention. So I can fucking kill him!
Guess your new girlfriend wasn't all she was cracked up to be.
What the hell is your problem? You refused to give me my day's rations back at the motor lodge. And you went out of your way to be an asshole to me tonight. You must really hate me.
Of course I do.
But guess what?
You made me hate
You're
you.
Stuck with me. I plan to be around
really.
Long after you're gone.
Hope they get him
and
eat his ass.
Turn, I'll be the one to put the axe through your skull.
Dad!
Open up, goddammit!
No, you're not worth the energy to hate.
Don't forget, I know who you really are. Come on, show yourself!
Your dad's not making things any easier for us.
Open the fucking
Dad,
door!
Dad, stop!
Goddammit! There's more of us on the way! Let us out now!
They got Katya and Duck, Lee. Those fuckers have my family.
I know. We're gonna get out of here and find them.
They're not gonna open the door.
You think a fucking apocalypse gives... I'll break that damn door down.
Dad, you can't get...
There you go. Good.
Easy.
Kill over.
Oh, God.
Dad?
Fresh meat. Fuck him.
No. Dad, come on. Dad! Oh, God. He stopped breathing. I think
he's
had a heart attack.
Shit. Is he dead?
He's not dead. Somebody help me.
Fuck. If he's dead...
He's not dead.
What has to happen, Lee? Think about it. You saw that poor bastard at the motel? How fast he turned?
What are you saying?
Lily, I'm sorry. I truly, truly am. But in a few minutes, we're going to be stuck
in
a locked room with a 6'4", 300-pound, seriously pissed off dead guy.
Fuck you! We can bring him back! Lee!
We'll mourn him later. But right now, we have to keep him from coming back.
No! God damn it, Kenny! He's not dead!
Maybe you're right.
No, god damn it! My dad survived worse than this!
Look, Kenny, back at the drugstore when we all thought Duck was bitten, I gave him the benefit of the doubt. Maybe we should do the same now.
That was different. Duck wasn't bitten. But come on! We know this guy's not gonna make it. Remember what Ben said. Gotta destroy the brain. Come on, Lee, I'm right about this. I know you've got my back. You always do.
God damn it, Lee, I need you! Please help me!
Come on, Dad. Come on. Wake up. Wake up! Come on!
You're right, Kenny. Let's get this
over. You fucking monsters!
Yeah.
Both of you!
I don't want to see...
Fuck your dad.
No.
I told you I was going to let him die.
Don't
I told you.
This.
Fuck him.
No! Let go of me!
You're going to get bit right in the face. Yeah, fuck him.
No!
That's right. Oh well. Good riddance. Fuck him.
God help us.
Sorry. Too bad.
Sorry. Don't you fucking touch me.
Fuck that fat piece of shit.
Clem.
You okay? Too much salt will kill you, Trophy.
He was dead, Clementine.
But what if he wasn't?
He was, I promise.
I'm sorry. It's okay.
I know.
The fat man is dead now. He's gone.
I need you to
be
strong.
He can't hurt you anymore.
Think about something else. Something hopeful.
Like what?
How about your walkie-talkie? Those pretend talks with your mom and dad. Don't those make you feel better?
Sometimes. We're gonna get out, right? You found a way out?
I'm working on it.
That's right. Fuck her dad. I should go over there spitting. See if there's an option to spit.
Get away.
I just need to...
I told you to get the fuck away!
Lily, I'm sorry.
Don't talk to me, Lee. Don't fucking talk to me.
Larry would have wanted...
Fuck you! You think he wanted this?
Of course not.
You don't know what he wanted. You never knew him. You never gave him a chance.
Maybe not.
Oh, yeah, right.
Maybe I should have tried
harder. He never gave me a chance.
But I know he loved
Fuck you. Out of there. Fuck him. Like I said, fuck your pop.
I want you to get out of here.
Fuck yo pop, nigga. Fuck yo pop. Fatnesses. Heart attack.
You think maybe we were too hasty?
Only one important thing right now. Getting the fuck out of here. We had to.
Pretty much.
What now?
You got any ideas?
The air conditioner. There might be a duck behind it.
Oh, God. What are they doing to catch a duck?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
There ought to be an air duct behind this unit. Maybe big enough for one of us to fit through.
I don't know, Lee. Seems like a long shot.
Does the air conditioner come off?
I think I could take it off if I had something to remove the screws. The multi-tool. Shit.
Maybe there's something else we could use. I've got a rock.
A rock won't help. But a coin might do the trick. Do you have a coin?
Maybe her fat fucking dead pop does.
If we can remove these screws, the AC should come down easily. It's not coming off that way. If we can remove these screws, the AC should come down easily. It's not coming off that way.
Old Get man always away. Got change. She acting like a rabid dog. You got a quarter.
Why can't you just leave me alone?
We just killed your pot. You got a quarter. How about a dime?
I'm sorry. But if we're gonna get out of here, we need your help. And Larry's. I think I may have found a way out of here. But I need something to remove the screws on the air conditioner. If you had something I could use as a screwdriver, a coin or something.
No.
What about him? Look, I know this is a terrible time for it, but back at the motor inn, Larry mentioned something about keeping coins in his pockets.
In other words, my father's more useful to you dead than alive.
Yes, if he was alive, that's true.
Had the key to getting us out of here.
Fuck him.
Do you think he'd keep it to himself?
What do you want? My blessing to loot his corpse?
Your permission.
Do what you have to do.
Fuck your pop. punk motherfucker.
Oh, boy. Any idea which pocket he keeps his change in?
You fucking vulture.
She might turn on me later, but I don't give a fuck. Fuck him.
Here we go. 2 quarters.
Change.
And a dime.
And a dime. Most likely gonna need the dime. Quarters is usually too big for shit like that.
Just gotta remove these screws and get this unit off.
Yeah. Okay.
You got it?
Yeah. One more should do it. Clementine can fit through.
Looks like it'll probably lead right into that back room.
Need your help, Clementine.
You think you can do this?
I'm scared.
It's okay to be scared.
We need you, Clementine.
Okay.
You're gonna be fine.
What do I do when I get out?
See if you can get to the other side of that door and open it.
That's what his face be looking like when he's scared. Nah, he was going up the stairs too late. Those scared, big-eyed black dude look. Uh-oh. She made it. She made it. I know she made it. Good girl.
Are you okay? Did anyone see you?
No, but there's a man outside.
Lily, gotta go.
Leave me alone.
Lee, I can see him.
It's not safe in here.
For God's sake, Lee. Didn't even get to say goodbye.
Yes, he did.
Get in.
He's
here.
Pumping on his chest.
Stay
saying
here.
Goodbye there.
Take care of Lily, okay?
I will.
Fuck your dad. Punk motherfucker. That was real satisfying.
Something up with this room. It's a goddamn human slaughterhouse.
I want that one.
Maybe I shouldn't have seen Clementine through there. This room would give anybody nightmares. God, what's wrong with these people? Jesus, this is where they butcher people.
Sick bastards. All of them.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, it's gonna be fun electrocuting somebody. This is gonna be fun. Hey, so let's see him.
Just forget about Lily right now. What are we gonna do about this guy at the front of the barn?
Take him the fuck out.
So what's the plan?
That dumbass is so caught up in his own rant that we could probably sneak right up on him. Just stick behind me in case anything goes down. When we get to the front, grab his gun.
Sounds good.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah, let's go.
Stay close.
Shock the shit out of him right in the ring.
It ain't right making me stay out here all night. I didn't do nothing. They just treat me like I'm some kind of screw-up.
Dad, what are you doing outside the barn?
Oh, shit. Just guarding the place, like you said.
Quit sitting out in the rain like a damn deer.
What's he doing out there?
We can't keep that many people alive and not expect trouble. Get one to keep and kill the rest.
Not good.
I'll keep an eye on him. Get ready to act what I say.
See what he's doing, Dad.
Oh, I know, man.
What's he doing now?
This is my favorite part, too. When I let one think they can just walk right out, they never even look down.
He's inside. He's not coming any closer.
See where he is now.
Nothing.
I don't see him anymore.
Where the fuck did he go?
I don't know.
Uh-oh.
Look at him. He didn't go past us. See where he is now.
Fuck. Oh, fuck. I just noticed his head grabbed the gun. God damn it. Go ahead. Ah, fuck. Yeah. Get him. Yeah. You punk bitch.
Where's my family, asshole? You can't have him. We need the vet.
No!
Can't! Lee, come on!
Just go. I won't be far behind.
Yeah.
You see? You understand now, don't you? You can have me. It's how the world works now.
What?
Get part of yourself so others can live.
That's why you killed that woman in the woods. She was about to spill everything.
You weren't ready to hear yet, Lee. Had to stop her. You gotta keep me alive. If you kill me, the meat gets tainted. You can't eat it.
You're already tainted.
You ain't gonna kill me.
Oh, yeah, I am. Yeah, I am. Oh, well. Clementine saw it. Fuck. Oh boy. Hey, Clementine. I mean for you to see that.
Gotcha!
Just go. I'll keep Clementine safe.
It's just the way the world works sometimes. Punk bitch. I'd do it again, too. Four of these in your chips. Cruel world out there, Clementine. Sorry, head. See that, baby? haunted house. Uh-oh. Now you got walkers too. Took him out. Okay.
Carly!
Lee?
Ow! Shh.
Ah.
Is that okay? We heard screams as we were coming up to the house.
We need your help.
Yeah, when you guys didn't come back, I figured something was up. What can we do?
Larry's dead. They chopped off Mark's legs and tried to feed him to us.
Shit. Is everyone else okay?
They've still got Doc and Katja in the house, and I don't know where the fuck Kenny is.
All right, we're coming in to help.
The main gate is too dangerous. Go around the fence and see if there's a back way in. I'll keep looking for Kenny. Do you have a weapon?
I don't leave home without it. Ben, stick close. And Lee, be careful.
You know you don't want to do this.
Just go away and leave us be. Stop right there. I mean it. Oh, I told you to stop. I told you.
Damn. Okay. Okay.
You just had to go snooping around, didn't you?
Let her go, Brenda!
Please, please don't you take another step!
Brenda, come on now, you know you don't want to do this!
Just go away and leave us be!
Doesn't have to end like this.
I'll kill her, Lee. Just let me go.
Oh shit! Look! 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 Oh shit! He turned. Oh my god.
Smart, how did it come to this?
Just stop.
This game is good.
I don't want to kill you, Lee.
This Derry was your pride. Look what you've done to it.
One more time.
Where's Kenny?
I said, don't move, asshole!
Don't you fucking hurt him!
Oh my god!
Let's go, goddammit!
Ah,
that ain't gonna happen!
And don't
shut up!
Oh, he shot him.
Andy, who the fuck do you people think you are? Look at what you've done.
Calm down.
Calm down? What for, huh? All we wanted was some goddamn gasoline.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, baby. Of course. I knew I'd be down.
Get up. Get the fuck up.
Really? Fuck! Fuck! Damn! Really, y'all? Really? Like that? Okay, seriously. Let's just move. Let him. What the hell is going on? Really? That's fucked. See, I told you she might turn on me. Yeah, all types of hands on you, buddy. It is what it is. Put my boot on you, cuz. Right to the face. Drop the savage at me. Fuck it. Sorry you had to see that, Clementine. What's wrong, man? What's wrong? You all right? Fight like a dairy farmer. Now, I'm sure that has messed some things up for me in the future of this game, but I don't care. I actually didn't think he was going to kill him. I thought he was going to kick him in the face and knock him out. But whatever. It is what it is. Look how she's looking at me.
Hey, Lee. I'd say I'm sorry for leaving the motel unattended, but, you know.
I'm glad you showed up when you did. If you hadn't taken that shot at Andy, we might not have gotten out of there.
Were they really killing people?
Yes, they were.
Food?
Yeah, and Clementine ate some. Oh, it's my fault. I panicked and didn't stop her.
You all right,
God.
Man?
Does she know?
She's not
stupid. Look wide awake now.
Katja managed to grab this while she was in the house. She said it was with your stuff.
Yeah. I found it while I was looking for the people who shot Mark.
Yeah.
Want it?
Why don't you keep it? Sometimes it helps to have something you can document.
I
want to
see what's on that, man.
Yeah,
he got shot. You all right, man?
I'll be fine. Just not as young as I used to be. Hun, go on ahead and give me and Lee a second. There's gonna be fallout.
For killing Lily's dad? Yeah, I would imagine so.
What do you think?
I'm with you, Kenny. We'll do what has to be done.
You're damn right.
Listen, you damn right, son.
The motor is just about ready. I've changed my mind. I want you to come with us when we leave.
Yeah?
Hell yeah. We're a team, man. Me and you. Taking out Larry before he turned, you saved all of us in that meat locker. And that saved my family, too. Yeah, I'd say you earned it.
If you're happy that that fat piece of trash is dead,
stay close.
Give me a hell yeah.
Men.
The comment section.
I shouldn't have done that. They were very bad men, Clementine, but that doesn't mean I had to kill them.
Why did you?
I wasn't thinking. I was angry. I was scared. But I did the wrong thing. You should never kill anybody unless you absolutely have to, okay?
Okay. Hey, Dad, what's that noise?
Oh.
Sounds like a car. Oh, God, not more strangers.
Maybe I'll start doing playthroughs. This is like Stone Cold and other voices. Would y'all like that?
Hello?
Boom.
figures.
Oh, crap. Baby, you gotta see this. It's a shitload of food and supplies back here.
This food could save all of us.
Not all of us.
Whatever.
Look, you don't know if these people are dead.
If they come back, then we're just monsters who came out of the woods and ruined their lives.
This stuff isn't ours. Dad, whose car is it?
Don't worry about that, Duck. It's ours now.
It's abandoned, Ducky. Don't worry.
What if it's not? Well, what if it's not abandoned? What if it is someone's?
Kids with that extra innocence.
You're right. We shouldn't take this.
What?
But
did you get some meal back there the rest of us missed out on? We have to take this stuff.
We've done enough damage already.
What do you mean by that?
Come on, Kenny. Between this and the meat locker, you know what it means.
Fine. Suit yourself. The rest of us are taking this stuff.
That's cool.
Okay, what have we got in here? Look, there's more food in that box.
Looks like some modern keys.
They have antibiotics. What else do they have?
See if there's any water.
Here. Got it?
Yeah, I got it. Lee, there's a hoodie in here. Could probably fit Clementine.
Are you cold? Are you chilly?
She's good. Thanks.
Whatever, man. It's gonna get cold out eventually.
Hey, there were some batteries in one of those boxes. I thought they might work in your camcorder. Here, you can have some too. For your walkie-talkie.
Batteries, huh? Think you can handle those?
You're not gonna let me live that down, are you?
Okay. I was trying to figure out what he was talking about.
Lee, you're gonna want to see this.
Uh-oh.
Oh, shit.
Oh. What was it? They were watching. Episode 2. Mm-hmm. Wow, man. Shit.
Make it is done, pal. Ain't nothing left. We gotta get the hell out of here. Lee, I need you to back me up on this.
Is this all you got?
I told you this town is tapped. Do you have any idea what we had to do to get all that? We need to leave. Duck was asking about the farm last night. Not much phases. It's starting to add up. I need to get to the coast. Get him out of all this madness. Lily's not doing so good, huh?
Remember, killed her dad.
We did kill her dad. Maybe people out there got things lined up better than us, at least. Could be folks who have all this shit figured out.
Do people get mad when they're scared?
It's
Sometimes.
Yeah, they do.
This is crazy.
I'm the one keeping this group going.
We can sort this all out, all right? We can sort this out.
I'll tell you what we need to sort out. We can't let one person fuck this up for everyone else.
The Walking Dead, Episode 3. Long Road Ahead. Chopped off David's leg, 43%. Interrogation, shot Jolene. Okay. Had Danny shoot her. Okay. Helped kill Larry, 49%. Yo, y'all, most, so you telling me, like, we basically were split 50-50. But one more percent of y'all let that motherfucker live. Fuck him. Revenge killed both the St. John brothers, being 38%. Fuck them brothers. Fuck them. And survival, stole the food from the car, 48%. Did not steal. This is interesting. Alright, y'all. So, you know what? I'll try. I'm not going to promise anything. I'll try to do an episode a day. That was pretty fun to do that. So, tonight, I'm going to try to do those What Culture videos as far as reaction. And I'm going to try to get to episode 3 of Making a Murderer. Alright? Because I know a lot of y'all are watching me on riff.tv. So anyway, post your comments down below. Let me know what y'all thought. If you enjoyed my gameplay, hit the like button, subscribe, and share. If you did not, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe, and share. 1 million subscribers. Woo!